Thanks for tuning in, everyone. This is Roadkill Warlord. Today I'm showing you a tutorial of how to play Duck Hunt on the Samsung Gear VR. First, you'll need a Samsung Gear VR with the controller. Next, you'll need an emulator. The emulator I use is called Notalgia NES, and you'll also need the Duck Hunt ROM you intend to play. Because it's not possible to acquire the ROM legally, you will need to do a search on how to obtain a copy of your own. After you have a Notalgia NES and your ROM downloaded and installed on your device, insert your device into your Samsung Gear VR headset. Next, you'll come up to the Oculus VR menu and the Oculus options. From the bar, you'll want to select Search, and what you're searching for is the Samsung PhoneCast app. Once you get that pulled up, you can install that and go ahead and launch it from this menu. The reason why we want to use PhoneCast is one of its features called Labs. Labs allows you to use some of the apps off your phone that normally wouldn't be compatible or usable in the Samsung PhoneCast or any of the VR applications that are available for it. So select the Labs icon, which is represented by a beaker, and that'll open your apps. Through the menus of all your apps on your phone, it'll let you use. You want to find that Notalgia NES Lite app, so you can just click on the letter N, and that'll launch that app. Now, sometimes when the app launches, it'll ask you to give it some permissions or other apps for permissions, and it will most likely on your first run search for all and any ROMs you have installed on your device. They'll be listed alphabetically, and what you'll want to do is scroll through that list to find the app you'd like to launch. In this case, mine is Super Mario Brothers and Duck Hunt Combo, because I'm a big fan of that combo ROM. And once that launches, if you've played this before or done any of this before, even on your phone, it may launch from one of your save states, which is the case in my demonstration video today. So what you want to do is in the top right-hand corner, there's a three little dots or a series of ellipses, and that'll open up all the options on whether you can map your controller, or in this case we just want the reset button and the zapper option. So if your zapper's turned off, you can go through all of these options just pressing the on screen keys, but make sure before each time you want to play you turn that zapper gun back on. And once you get all that done, you're ready to play. So enjoy. Thanks for tuning in. If you like what you saw, please like and subscribe, as I'll be adding more of these types of videos. Keep playing, and Happy New Year!